Hey, well, it's Friday. That means we should be having a dueling Excel podcast. You know, Mike, if you saw on YouTube, had a pretty bad accident. He tripped and broke his wrist. He's been having typing problems. He'll be back next week, though. So for this Friday, just doing a regular podcast. MrExcel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from MrExcel Podcast, episode 1415, SumRed. Well, hey, welcome back to the MrExcel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, sent in by Adam. Adam is actually a member of the audience in my CFO Magazine webcast talking about macros. And just, it wasn't a macro thing. I just happened to mention during that webcast that you could filter by color. So filter by color and choose the font color and get all those. He said, hey, that was a pretty cool trick. Is there any way to sum by color? And this is an old one. There's no native way to sum in color, but hey, it was a webcast about macro. So of course I don't feel bad giving a macro answer. Let's say we wanted to sum all the red cells in this range. The first thing I have to do is figure out what color that really is. So I'm gonna do a couple of keystrokes here. I'm gonna do Alt F11. And then Control G. Control G brings up the immediate window, and I'm going to say print active cell dot font dot color. And I'm going to see that cell is 342. Well, how am I going to remember that? Okay, we'll come back to that one. I'll make this a little bit smaller. And then what we're going to do is we're going to insert a new module. So insert module, and I'm going to create a little function here. It's going to be called function sum red, and we have to tell it which cells we want to look at. So I'm going to say my range as range. It's important to say as range. That way it knows that it's not just passing a value, it's passing a range of cells. And then what we're going to do is we're going to say for each cell in my range, if cell.font.color is equal to, and I have this stuff still down here in the immediate window, I'll copy that, Control C, paste. Then, all right, okay, so if that's true, then we need to add this cell to the total. Now the total is going to be a variable called SumRed. It has to be called SumRed because that's the name of the function. Now I really should initialize this up here. SumRed is equal to 0. And we can say SumRed is equal to SumRed plus cell.value. All right, end if, and then next cell. Say, okay, well, now how do we return that back to the spreadsheet? That's the beautiful thing. Because it's called SumRed, that automatically gets written back out to the spreadsheet. All right, now let's try this. We're going to file, close, and return to Microsoft Excel. And we'll say equal SumRed, that whole big range there. Bam, 255. Let's just do a little test. Oh, no, the red one's here. Bam, 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 bam. Down at the bottom, 255, that works great. Now, what if you wanted to use fill color instead? If you wanted to sum the orange, well, let's switch back to VBA, Alt F11. We'll do function sum orange fill. And let's see, so here we need to change the name of that. And this time, instead of activeCell.font.color, we ask for activeCell.interior.color. Now I need to make sure that I'm in the right cell. Let's see, choose one of those orange cells. Press enter. Okay, so that's a different code. So we say if cell.interior.color is equal to 9, then sum orange fill is equal to sum orange fill plus that cell's value. So try that. Sum orange fill this whole range. 293, which should be the sum of the orange, orange cells. Okay, so if you just had, 293, if you just had a quick and dirty need, you could knock out a tiny little macro like that. You know, but what would be much more flexible is to write a function that could handle any color. And so I created this function called SumColor, and the way that it works is the first thing you have to specify is what color you're trying to add up. So if I want all of the red cells, for example, and then the range you want to sum, So that should be 45, which is 45. That's great. Now, if you wanted to use a fill color, there's an optional third argument out here called bifill, and you would use true there, and that will sum up all of the yellow cells. All right, so let's take a look at that code. Here I'm passing three arguments, sample color as range, range to sum as range, and then this is a continuation character here, an optional argument bifill as boolean. Now, one really important thing here with all of these functions, if the color is going to be changing, you have to put application.volatile in there, so that way it'll recalculate with the rest of the spreadsheet. Otherwise, Excel doesn't know that this is something that has to be recalculated. It won't be in the calculation chain. And then check to see whether we're looking for either the interior or the font, and then loop through and on each cell, either check to see if it's equal to the interior or the font, and then add it up. So there's a much more flexible function and easier way to go. Well, hey, I want to thank Adam for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.